I'll be flustered. I've got to work in a foreign environment. During the service. All right, to go? Okay. Well, good morning and thank you for coming in on what is day one of the 2014 National Road Safety Campaign Program. A very important day for us in terms of road safety, as will be the next few months for road safety. This year, for the first day of the campaign, there have been zero fatalities on Queensland roads, which is a great outcome in terms of the overall road toll for the year, which is trending in a very positive way compared to previous years. I'd like to acknowledge and thank the motorists of Queensland for the contribution they've made in terms of road safety, not only in this particular program year, but also more broadly across a couple of years. But this year is going very well, and I thank the motorists of Queensland for what they've done.
Ian Stewart said to me that it's looking like we'll have the least amount of road deaths in recorded history this year if it keeps going like we are.
That's right. The road toll year to date is 221, which is 48 less on a year to date comparison to last year. It's also significantly less than the 2010 year, which was the best year in recorded history. But we asked motorists not to drive to the road toll, but to drive to the road conditions. And every day should be a day for road safety, no matter what activity you're doing on the road.
Could you explain about this Mates Motel? Is that something that you...
The Queensland Transport and Main Roads are running a program called Join the Drive. It's been running over a few years now. It's a very successful program. Part of the program for this year is Mates Motel, which you can access through the Join the Drive website. What it's saying to people in Queensland is if you have people coming to your residence for a party or a get-together over the next few days, few weeks, plan your stay and plan their stay with you by declaring your home a mate's motel. Make your mates welcome and keep them off the road if they've had too much to drink.
Is there going to be scheduled operations by police and targeted for drink driving or speeding or things like that? Or?
We're focusing on the Fatal Five this year, but predominantly over the Christmas campaign, we've got a great interest in drink driving and also in speeding. This week in Brisbane, we saw a man detected for driving at a blood alcohol reading of 0.34. That's almost seven times the legal limit. That's not acceptable, and that man will need to explain his actions before a court. We've also seen in recent days people travelling at excessive speeds, and speeds which, in my opinion, are not justifiable. People doing 40 and 50 kilometres over the speed limit according to the signed zones. So we would ask people to drive to the speed limits, drive to the road conditions, and absolutely don't drink and drive.
Do you think about those people, about that do have a drink on Christmas or New Year's and then still go ahead and risk it?
We all know what the road rules are and what the limits are for drink driving. If you're having a drink, don't drive. If you're unsure whether you are over the limit, don't drive. Find another way of getting to where you need to be. We will have special programs in place over the next 10 to 12 days and then more broadly through to January, encouraging people to drive according to the conditions and to detect people who are taking the risk of drink driving.
Mike, a lot of people will be leaving for quite lengthy drives this afternoon after work to get to places for Christmas. What do you implore them to do in terms of having those rest breaks?
Well, we need the recommended strategy is to take a rest every 2 hours. Queensland is a very diverse state. We have many visitors who come to our state at this time of year who are not used to the driving conditions. We would ask you to manage your fatigue. Take a rest regularly. If you've been driving for a long period of time, take a longer break. If you're feeling fatigued or tired, don't set off on a long journey until you've had a proper rest. If you're driving in our roads, manage your fatigue and manage your safety.
Are you disappointed at the number of positive roadside drug tests already?
Well, we'd like to see nobody tested and go over the limit. That's absolutely why we do the testing, is to encourage people to drive to the conditions and to drive to the standards that we expect. We see many more people tested than we see detected for drink driving, but we do get concerned when we see so many people detected. We see one man was detected for driving at 0.34 in the last few days. That's just unacceptable, and I would suggest that most Queenslanders would see that as poor behaviour and would not accept that as a reasonable standard of practice.
What about the 7 positive drug tests at this stage? I mean, looking at last year's figures, there was 0 54 tests, already 37 tests and 7 positive.
We've been doing considerably more drug testing in the last few months than we've done previously, and we intend to expand that program into 2015. We have a lot of work going on behind the scenes with regard to drug testing. There's absolutely no doubt that if you are impaired, whether it be through drugs or through alcohol, you increase the risk to yourself, to your passengers, and to other road users. If you've been using illicit drugs, don't drive a car. If you've been drinking alcohol and you're over the prescribed limit, don't drive a car.
Cool.
Great, thanks for your interest.
Thank you very much.